roaring across farmland alarmingly close to homes. This house in Baldiva, south of Perth, surrounded by smoke and charred ground. Down the road, another house under threat, a tree still on fire. There's panic and confusion. Locals fearing the worst, evacuating their animals or setting them free to escape the danger.
There's horses down the stables, which we've got no float to evacuate them, but they're just going to have to let them go.
Hot, dry winds are again proving a challenge along the east coast. A severe weather warning is in place and beaches and roads are closed.
We've currently got 2,600 people committed to fires at the moment, and we've got another 1,000 on standby in strike teams right across the at-risk areas.
In the New South Wales town of Cobargo, another hazard, deadly asbestos among the debris of fire-ravaged homes. The state's premier now promising an independent review into the fire season.
It's important for us to take the learnings from this season.
South Australia's Kangaroo Island is still burning. One third has been blackened, rain giving the ecological sanctuary some reprieve today.
We've got a few days of cool southwesterlies where we need to establish our control lines.
Support is being ramped up for Australia's native wildlife. It's thought more than a billion animals have perished in the flames.
Of course, a crisis like this is going to have an impact for over a decade. The long game in this is restoring the habitats that the surviving wildlife has come from.
Tonight, other animals and their owners are sleeping side by side, waiting for a break from the fires and a decent sleep. Ryan Boswell, One News, Sydney.